Hello Pisces, welcome to my channel. So today we've got a general timeless reading for you. We're going to do a Celtic cross and see what wants to come out. With it being general, it's not going to resonate for every Piscean out there, so do check out your moon, rising, Venus, any stellium you might have, even the descendant could hold some value to you. If you want to reach out for a private reading, details are in the description box. If so wish, and thank you for the likes, shares and subscribes. It's really helps me circulate the videos on YouTube and grow the channel, which is the main aim. So if you want to keep seeing me doing what I do, and you haven't done so already, please do so. Much appreciated. Okay, Pisces, what do we got for you? Okay, there's the heart of the matter. It's crossing your subconscious, past, what you want, the future, how you see yourself, how others see you, advice. And the outcome. Okay. Bottom of the deck, King of Wands with the Magician and the Four of Cups. Could be dealing with an Aries. Or a Gemini, possibly. Somebody feels like they've missed an opportunity with you. Potential reconciliation going on here, I think. Possibly with a Capricorn. So, heart of the matter. Conflict. Conflict, conflict, conflict. What's crossing you is the Nine of Pentacles. Okay, yeah, you're conflicted because I think someone's in your life, someone's come in, and you love being single, and now you're conflicted because you've really met somebody that's hit the spot, so to speak. Could be a Capricorn. So we're the devil here later on. So I'm not picking any sort of, I mean, we will clarify all these, but I'm not picking any sort of addictions going on there. In your subconscious, the Ace of Pentacles, you know this person's a gift. You know this person's a gift for you. But you're so conflicted because you love being single. Yeah, I understand. Losing your, I mean, you can have a relationship without losing your independence. Set barriers, to begin with. I don't mean set blocks type of thing, but you know, if you have certain things that you do with your friends, continue doing them. You don't have to give everything up. You don't have to lose your independence to be in a relationship. And I kind of feel like you're fearing that's what's going to happen. In the past, you've got the Ace of Swords. You've got two aces here so far. This is truth. This is clarity. And it's also a gift as well. I think this person's come in and it's a gift. Could be an air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. But with the Ace of Pentacles here, I think you know it. You know this person's supposed to be with you. You know, you're supposed to be together. What you want is a Nine of Cups. You want wish fulfillment, essentially, which is good. And I think you're going to get it with this person. Your future is the Hangman. Things are stagnant at the moment. I'm not taking this as an, I'm taking this as you. It's just you. You're turning up and you're reading. Is the power I'm getting here. I'm not getting any sort of stagnation. I kind of feel like you're looking at yourself in another light. This ability to have the best of both worlds. A relationship which is also balanced with freedom, essentially. Because even though he's hung upside down, you know, he's got himself there. He's happy. He's not trapped. He's not bound, as in been put there by somebody else. He's happily just contemplating life there. But I'm more taking this as just you in your energy. How you see yourself is judgment. This is you making a decision about this situation. You know, do you do a level of commitment, or do you stay being single? It's a choice that you need to make. How others see you is the sun. It could be dealing with Leo, or you could have it in the chart. They see it's the happiest card in the deck. They want everything with you. Fantastic. Beautiful. Part of me thinks that you might be in separation with this person at the moment. Something never really got off the ground. And you're not currently in... You're currently in separation, put it that way. Your advice, two of ones, make a decision. You're thinking about the decision, make it. And the beauty thing is, I think you choose this. I think there's a reconciliation here. So we've got the Three of Cups, the King of Pentacles, and the Devil. I think the Devil is Capricorn energy. I think either you or your person has heavy Capricorn in their chart. Not necessarily sun sign. For some of you, it is a sun sign, with the sun being here. Others, they could have Saturn in their chart, or Capricorn in Saturn. We got the King of Pentacles here. This is a card of ultimate commitment. So I kind of feel that's what you choose. And I don't think you're going to be sad about that. Because I think one of the reasons why the Three of Cups is here is not only a card of reconciliation, but it's also a card of socialising with your friends. So I don't think you lose your independence. I think it's going to be a nice balance. Looks a good relationship, Pisces. I mean, not bad at all. I mean, I think it's something that's manifested. And I kind of, the reason why I kind of feel like there's no contact at the moment is because we've got the Four of Cups and the Five of Cups. It's like this missed opportunity and sadness. So I kind of feel like you're in separation with this person. They may be at a distance from you. Two of Wands overlooking over the sea, you know, waiting, pondering. Right, let's get some clarifiers. I'm pretty confident what I've said's pretty spot on, but you know what, they might just throw me a curveball here, you never know. Right. One more. Beautiful. Brilliant. Okay, bottom of the deck, Seven of Pentacles, Three of Pentacles, and the Fool. They want to build something with you. You know, the seed is planted. They want a fresh start and to build something new with you. Sorry, I'm holding these terrible. There's been hurt in the past. It's time to move on together. So, the issue, Five of Swords with the Five of Pentacles. This kind of conflict that you're going through in yourself, you know, the choices that you need to make. I think you're in separation at the moment. I think this person feels like they've left out in the cold. Crossing you is this need for independence. The Lovers is a decision card, Gemini energy. You need to make that decision. You know, do you stay single or do you commit? The Ace of Pentacles is in your subconscious. This is a gift from the universe in which you know about it. With the Ten of Wands, it's putting... Subconsciously, it's really weighing heavily on your mind, is this. I kind of feel like you think you've made a mistake. And we'll get to that in a minute. In the past, Ace of Swords. This person, again, is a gift. They've come in to heal you, is what I'm hearing here. Aquarius energy, they've come in to heal you. They could be healers themselves, for some of you, but I kind of feel like it's just going to bring truth and clarity to your life. Maybe there's a bit of fear of abandonment surrounding you, for some of you out there anyway. What you want is the Nine of Cups, this wish fulfillment with the Ten of Pentacles, commitment, family, wealth, money, everything, essentially. You want commitment. It's weird. You want commitment. but you don't. You want commitment, but you want your own lifestyle. I kind of feel like you're going to have a happy balance here. And the reason why I say that is because, lo and behold, the Six of Pentacles has shown up. But we'll get to that. So, currently, you're in your power, I feel, in the future. With the King of Swords, you could have your own business, especially with the Ace of Pentacles here. I kind of see you just... I have to wait until that come through. You've changed your perspective. You're going from wanting to be independent to wanting to be a commitment. And it's... The King of Swords is cutting through the cloud, cutting through the mist, essentially, bringing clarity to your situation of what you actually want. Because how you see yourself is judgment, is making this decision about single life or commitment life. It's making you sad. You're looking at your past, the decisions you've made to turn this person away, possibly. You've maybe done it three times. Three cups on the ground. You may have turned this person down three times for some of you out there. But the decision needs to be made. I think you've also had a realization, by the way, with the judgment. It came out of nowhere. You've probably kept this person at a bay. Hooked up now and again. They've wanted more. You've kept them at a distance. But you've had a realisation that you need to stop doing that. You got 5, 5, and 5 here. 3 5s. Signifies major changes coming ahead. The Six of Pentacles is how how people see you, the sun. You know, they see everything in you. But I think this is more about bringing balance and fairness to the whole situation. Which is good. Your advice is a 2 of Wands and the 3 of Wands. Making a decision and moving on with it. Moving to that next stage of commitment is what I get there. The 3 of Cups, the King of Pentacles and the Devil is clarified, the 8 of Swords, 4 of Cups and the Page of Wands. I see this as, it's saying that you're trapped in the same circles, like you're in a routine with your friends. And I kind of feel like it's coming out like mundane, like the routine's getting boring now. So maybe this independent routine is just not satisfying you anymore. So I kind of see that this person's, there's a lot of passion here. You know, you fancy each other like nobody's business. The Page of Wands and the King of Wands here. I kind of feel like there's a message coming in, either you to them or them to you, which is going to bring a reconciliation, I think. You know, you're going to go from this focusing on the negative to then focusing on 3 of Cups, you know, reconciliation type of thing. With the King of Pentacles here, like I say, it's ultimate commitment, and that with the 10 of Pentacles here again, you're going to have it all. You're going to have the home. You're going to have stability. You're going to have finances. Very, very beautiful finances. And you're going to have a family, which I think is what you want. Deep down. Okay? Lift off that mask, Pisces, if it is for you. It could be for your person. But I'm reading for you, so I'm going to say it's you. Lift off that mask. Stop pretending you want one thing and... when you really want another, because I kind of feel that's the energy here. Okay. Maybe that's what the Devil's representing, a false mask. Alright, Pisces. So you could be dealing with a fellow Pisces, you could be dealing with an Aquarius, Gemini, Leo, Scorpio, Capricorn. But we've got everybody. We've got Swords, we've got Cups, we've got Wands, we've got Pentacles, everybody's here, but those are your standouts. So yeah, reconciliation's coming, I think, once you've made that decision that commitment is what you want. And you're going to be very happy and very well blessed. Okay, Pisces, look after yourself. Let me know if it resonates. Thank you for the likes, shares and subscribes. It means the world. And I'll see you next time. Cheers. Bye.